enjoy the show.
Choco.
I'm Nicolette Santino.
Peggy Etra.
Jess McKay.
We are Henson Alternatives Puppet Up Uncensored, and Henson Alternative is a branch of the Jim Henson Company. So we're taking all that tradition of puppetry and stuff, but we're bringing it to a live, improvised stage show that is completely different every single night. It's completely off the cuff. We take suggestions from the audience, and they kind of even guide us in the show.
Well, we improvise, so what happens is that we have 60 to 70 puppets that we can choose from off the rack, and we don't know what puppet we're going to use until the improv is announced by our director, Patrick, and then we'll figure, like, oh, you know, that this puppet would be great for that. And so that's our playground. That's our cast.
And what's cool about our show is that it's really two shows in one. A lot of times, like on, puppets on television, you just see the puppet. But on our show, you can watch the puppet on screens on either side of the stage, or you can watch the puppeteers and see how we perform the puppets that you're seeing on the screen.
In addition to the improv, we're also going to be recreating some classic Jim Henson puppet sketches. So that's really one of my favorite parts of the show. It really brings the history of this art form back to life.
My name is Daniel Miller. I'm one of the maze designers.
And I'm Eric Nix, a producer here at Not Scary
Miranda.
Farm. Even with our older mazes, we know we have such a large annual pass holder base that comes year over year and sees our mazes and our offerings. So things like Dark Ride, The Depths, even Infected, they're all getting plus ups this year. We always like to look at those mazes and say, you're going to see it another year. So what can we do to change it up a little bit?
My new attraction is called Waxworks. It revolves around a wax house of wax. And there's an evil curator who basically has brainwash all these people who've come in. The waxworks is burnt down, melted down, and all these people who come in, they are kidnapped and then brainwashed, and they occupy this dilapidated waxworks. It's all melted and gross.
Think of it like a multiverse or like a larger universe. And really, all of our attractions have always been connected in some sort of way. There's little Easter eggs in a lot of our mazes that connect to another maze or another storyline. So we really try and create one universe that's telling one story. And this year, we're really trying to drive it home with Origins and Ghost Town and The Hanging. It's a tough decision to make, for sure. Something as popular as Infected and even Shadowlands have had such great runs for so many years. But really, we look at guest feedback, and then we look at the designers too, and we see what they bring to the table each year. We really handpick and say, that's a great idea. We need to bring that to the forefront and really fabricate it and get that in front of everyone. So it's tough to give up the ones that we really love, but we got to make room for new and improved and innovative new ideas. So we're looking forward to what will replace Shadowlands and Infected next year.
John Cook.
Ted Doherty. I'm writer and director of the Not Scary Farm Maze Origins, The Curse of Calico.
Which we're very excited about. This year we co-created Origins, and we're able to tell the official backstory of Ghost Town. So we're very excited about being honored with that task. Oh man, we're bringing it to life actually as we speak. No, but we sat down and this is not a task that we took lightly at all, and we wanted to make sure we were paying the correct homage to this event that we love. So when we decided to create this maze, we wanted to start right where those original witch hangings left off.
Yeah, because what better content to tap into than the longest running show in Not Scary Farm's history.
And one of the really unique things about this maze is it's about Ghost Town. It's it's in Ghost Town. It takes place in Ghost Town, and so we have a really awesome, seamless transition into the experience. So our experience is actually starting in the queue, which is Blue Hill Cemetery. So that's where we get to begin telling this, setting up the story that the guests are actually playing the role of the angry towns mob that's out to find the witch as they go through the experience. And one of the really neat things too, it never ends. Once you leave the attraction, you're now plunged into Ghost Town streets. Your journey continues. Yes, I mean, for us to be able to, like I said, to officially tell that, like, it's pretty exciting.
No, it's very exciting. I mean, this is the very first time that Not Scary Farm has ever created a maze that revolves around an existing property, which is the Ghost Town Scare Zone. So super exciting.